This is the budding light of hope and knowledge, the delight of Sri Prakash Educational Institutions, spreading academic brilliance in all directions.
Namaste students, I am Varahalu, one of your language teachers. I am very glad to meet you all. How are you? Are you ready to attend today's online classes? In today's video, we are going to learn a lesson called A Tale of Two Birds. I hope every one of you would like this video and learn thoroughly about the lesson A Tale of Two Birds. Wish you a happy learning.
Aim of this video is to make you understand the importance of company or association, to make you grasp the moral of the story, to encourage you to have good friends or association, to promote reading habit for pleasure among you. Watch video and learn about the lesson A Tale of Two Birds, improve LSRW skills, read, understand and comprehend the text, work with the text by answering the questions given in page number 3 of A Pact with the Sun. Word in focus. Today's word is announce. Announce is a verb meaning to give public notice. Conjugation: announce, announced, announced, announcing, announces. Derivatives are announcement, announcer, both are nouns. Announceable is an adjective, announcedly is an adverb. Usages are: she announced her intention to retire. Announced is a verb. The company president made an announcement about the merger. Announcement is a noun. Let's learn about the lesson A Tale of Two Birds. Before we go further, let's watch a video on A Tale of Two Birds.
Two Birds. Once upon a time, there lived a beautiful bird in the forests of Udhampur. She lived happily with her friends and neighbors on a wise old banyan tree. She loved the forest for it provided ample food and places to fly around. One year, she gave birth to two little birds. The newborn lived in a nest she built on the tree. She cared for her babies deeply and loved them very much. The tree, too, spread out its branches lovingly around the babies. Day and night she cared for them and fed them well. Alas, one unfortunate day, the forest experienced a storm like never before. Thunder, lightning, strong winds scared all the birds and animals. Many trees got uprooted. The bird hid in her nest, trying to feel secure and praying fervently. Suddenly, a heavy branch broke and came crashing down. The bird was killed instantly. The kids were saved, though. They were blown away by a gentler wind to the other side of the forest. One fell at the entrance of a cave. Many robbers lived inside this cave. The other sibling fell at the doorsteps of a blessed rishi's ashram. Time slowly passed by and the birds gradually grew up. They were now big birds like their mother once had been. They had grown into mature birds with characters of their own. One fine day, King Harshvardhan of Purvasa visited the forest. He was a well-known hunter and wanted to hunt a game. He was busy chasing a deer and in the process went deep into the forest while chasing the deer. His soldiers slowly lost track and the king was left alone in the jungle. He didn't know where he was, and neither did he know the way out. The king was truly bewildered. He was tired after the long day and hungry too. He had reached the other end of the forest. He decided to take a break and sat down under a huge shady banyan tree. He was taken aback when he heard someone say, "Hey, come quickly! There's someone under the banyan tree. He has a horse and is wearing fine jewels. Take his things away before he rides away." The king looked around and could only see a bird perched on the tree. He could hear a commotion emanating from a cave. He lost no time in riding away to safety. He was relieved to see an ashram in a small clearing. He could see many ascetics going about their work. King Harshvardhan tethered his horse near the stream. Someone spoke up. "O mighty king, I welcome you to this holy place. You look tired. Please take rest. Rishi Agastya will be back soon. You can have this water. You do look thirsty." The king was overcome with gratitude. He looked at the bird. It looked very similar to the one he had seen some time back on the banyan tree. The bird read his thoughts and said, "I think you have recently come across my brother. He has made friends with the robbers and behaves like them. I am sorry if he misbehaved with you." The rishi entered the ashram and saw the king standing there. He welcomed the king warmly and invited him to the cottage for dinner. Over dinner, the king narrated his strange experience with the two look-alike birds. "This forest is unique and surprising." The rishi smiled knowingly. He said, "O king, one is known by the company one keeps. The bird you met in the morning has been in the company of robbers. The bird you met here has been in this holy place since a long time. He behaves like he watches everyone doing. Now come, don't spend any more time thinking about this. Take rest." Long after the king had returned to his palace, he kept thinking about the birds and the lesson they taught him unknowingly.
The story is all about a mother bird and her two young ones in a forest. The mother bird was taking care of her babies in a tall shady tree. One day a fierce storm came and it made all the trees fall down. A big branch hit the nest and the mother bird was killed. But luckily the baby birds were blown away to the other side of the forest and were saved. One of them reached a cave of robbers, the other one landed near a rishi's ashram. After a few days, the baby birds became bigger. One day, the king of the country reached the forest. He was hunting. While hunting, he noticed a deer and started chasing it. The deer ran away into the forest. Chasing the deer on horse, the king lost his way. The king kept riding and reached the other side of the forest. He got down from his horse as he was tired and sat under a tree near the cave. All of a sudden, he heard a voice asking to be quick and rob the person outside of his everything, jewels, horse. The king was surprised to hear that and looked up to check. He noticed a big brown bird on that tree and faint noises coming from the cave. Quickly, he mounted the horse and ran away. Soon he reached an ashram. The king tied his horse to a tree and sat down in its shade. Here he heard a soft voice which greeted him and asked him to come inside and take rest. It also told him to have cold water from the pot and be at ease till the rishi comes. Surprised, the king looked up to check and again found a similar big brown bird in the tree. The rishi greeted the king and requested him to come inside and be at ease. He also offered to share his food. The king explained the different behaviors of the two birds who looked alike. He added that the forest was full of such surprises. The bird told the king that he was right. The bird was his brother but had befriended robbers. He too had become like them. The bird added that he and his brother no longer talked to each other. Just then the rishi entered the ashram. The rishi smiled and explained the impact of the company one keeps. The bird who heard robbers was repeating their words and the one who was with the rishi was speaking softly and was greeting the people. The rishi asked the king to take rest and offered to tell him more about the birds and the place.
The big question of the lesson is, does our association influence our behavior and character? Let's have an activity. Write a paragraph on how your friends and family influence on your behavior. Please pause your video and complete the activity. Vocabulary. Blow down, meaning to make fall. A lot of trees were blown down in the recent storms. Alike. Similar or identical. The twins look alike, but they differ in temperament. Imitate, meaning copy. He can imitate the cries of birds. As a part of active listening activity, let's listen to the summary of A Tale of Two Birds. After completion of my reading, please you also read by following the correct pronunciation. The story revolves around two birds who took birth from the same mother but grew in the company of two different people. The story starts with a big storm. The storm carries the two birds away. The big storm caused the death of the mother bird and the separation of two young birds. One young bird got the shelter in a cave where robber lived, while another bird got the company of a saint in an ashram. First bird. Once a king went to the jungle for the hunt. While hunting for a deer, he went far into the forest. He took shelter under a tree near the cave. This tree was also the shelter of the first bird. This bird in the company of robber had become like the robber and talked like them too. He alarmed the robber that someone has come here. Take his jewels and the horse and kill him. King heard the bird and ran away from the cave. Second bird. During the course of running, the king arrived at an ashram which accompanies the second bird. The second bird said to the king, "Take rest and be comfortable. The rishi will arrive here soon." The king narrated the bird about the previous incident. The bird gasped and answered, "The first bird is my brother. He got the company of robbers and has become like them. I have asked him for change, but he doesn't listen to me." The king thought that both birds were alike in appearance, but their nature was completely opposite to the other. Rishi's teaching. Soon the rishi arrived. He welcomed the king. The king told the story of the two birds. The rishi gave him the moral of the story that a person is recognized by the people who are friends to him. The first bird got the company of the robber and became like that, while the second bird lived in the company of saint. So he became like the saint. The king took the blessing from the rishi and returned to his home. We should make friends with the people who are of good nature. If we take the company of bad people, we will also become bad. This story speaks and depicts the importance of the company one keeps, how one's company can impact one's behavior and build a character. One is known by the company one keeps. The birds were brought up in different environments and their behavior and personality was shaped according to that. Choosing the right friends can have a great impact on one's life. As a part of entertainment, let's watch videos on bird song and the company you keep. I hope every one of you would like these videos.
My food, food, food. I destination. Where they're gonna go on the next vacation. Gotta make that flashy reservation. Don't wanna wait in line. But when I'm sitting on the couch and I'm looking at the pictures, the background's only a secondary fixture. Where we went for dinner, shoot, I don't remember. But we had a good time together. Together, we can do whatever, whatever. We can walk right up the street where the locals roll. We ain't gotta go international, maybe just having a parking party. We don't need no Hollywood suite. Ooh. Don't matter what we do, and the thing with you sounds fine to me. It's all about the company you keep. Yeah, about the company. Cares where you had your birthday, just who was there. Buy you a shot, then hold back your hair, take you to Waffle House. Well, the circles that you're running when you're running around, bail you out, make you laugh, pick you up when you're down. Hanging out in your hometown, hey, that's what it's all about. Whatever, whatever, we're all in it together. Birds of a feather, we can walk right up.
Like the videos that were shown as a part of entertainment on bird song and the company you keep.
As a part of speaking activity, speak a few words on one is known by the company one keeps to your family members.
I hope every one of you have liked this video and learned thoroughly about the lesson A Tale of Two Birds. Thank you for watching this video and thank you very much.